Hello everyone, in this video I am going to discuss about the various factors that can lead to cancer. Before proceeding with the discussion, I would like to show you a case of squamous cell carcinoma. This is a case of 58-year-old male patient with squamous cell carcinoma of right buccal mucosa. This patient has a history of chewing pan masala since 10 years. This patient was treated with surgical excision of the tumor along with the radical neck dissection followed by radiotherapy. Okay, what is cancer? In the most basic term, cancer refers to cells that grow out of control and invade other tissues. Cancers are not found by one-time exposure or by several exposure over a short period of time, because the DNA is repaired by specific DNA polymerase enzyme. However, over a time and with the additive damage of several carcinogens, the sequential DNA damage exceeds the cell's DNA repair capability, leading to a permanently altered gene called as gene mutation. Coming on to the initiation of cancer. For a cancer to become initiated, a cell must accumulate at least 6 genetic mutations. These mutations must pass to daughter cells at the basement membrane, which retains these mutations and passes it on to its own daughter cells, which is further bombarded by carcinogens, and they pick up another non-lethal transferable mutation. Cancers are actually difficult to initiate and usually takes years of repetitive carcinogen exposure before they develop. Because DNA turnover is greater during the growing year, from birth to 20 year, DNA is more vulnerable to carcinogens if the patient come in direct or indirect exposure of the carcinogens. Now let's discuss the various factors that can lead to cancer. First is host factor. In host factor, first we are going to discuss about the age. Studies have reported maximum prevalence in the 5th and 6th decade of life. The observation that oral cancer generally occur with advancing age indicate that over the time, certain sequential alteration in the biochemical or biophysical processes, nuclear, enzymatic and metabolic immunological changes can lead to development of cancer. Aging cells with a particular genetic predisposition undergo and accumulate mutations resulting in carcinogenic transformation. Approximately 96% of oral cancer is diagnosed in person older than 40 years. The average age at the time of diagnosis is 63 years. Recently, evidence has emerged indicating that oral cancer are occurring more frequently in younger persons less than 40 years because of increasing habit of consuming alcohol and tobacco use. Now let's discuss the importance of gender. Oral cancer generally shows a greater incidence in males, and in males the most frequent site is mouth or oropharynx, followed by esophagus, stomach, respiratory tract, trachea, bronchus or lungs. And in case of female, the most common site of cancer is cervix, followed by breast, then mouth, then esophagus. Distribution. Most common site for oral cancer in descending order of frequency are tongue 25.4%, labial or buccal mucosa 21.7%, gingiva 14%, palate 9.9%, and alveolar mucosa 7.9%. One more thing, oral cancer are more common in blacks as compared to whites. Now, importance of heredity in cancer. We have not identified genetic cause for all types of cancer. We do know several gene changes or mutations that can be passed down from parent to child and increase a person's risk of developing the disease. These changes are known as hereditary cancer syndromes. Genetic studies have shown that neoplasms tend to occur in the families, but still no pattern of Mendelian inheritance has been discovered. Here are some syndromes in which there is a greater risk of developing cancer. First is Cowden syndrome. Cowden syndrome is characterized by multiple tumor-like growths and an increased risk of certain cancer. Cowden syndrome is associated with a mutation in the PTEN. Individual with Cowden syndrome have an increased risk of developing benign and malignant tumor of the breast, uterus and thyroid. Now coming on to the hereditary leukemia and hematological malignancy syndrome. Researchers have found about a dozen of inherited genetic conditions that can lead to leukemia and related blood diseases such as myelodysplastic syndrome, acute myeloid leukemia and aplastic anemia. Next is Leiferman syndrome. Is a rare genetic condition characterized by an increased risk of developing multiple types of cancer. Most individuals with Leiferman syndromes are found to have mutations in the TP53 gene. The most common types of cancer associated with this syndrome include soft tissue sarcoma, like tumor in fat, muscle, nerve, joint, blood vessels, bone or deep skin. Second, breast cancer, leukemia, lung cancer, brain tumors, adrenal gland cancer. Next is VHL disease. It is a multiple system disorder characterized by abnormal growth of blood vessels called hemangioblastomas or angiomas. Other types of tumors develop in the adrenal gland, kidney and pancreas. Mostly individuals with VHL disease are found to have mutation in the VHL gene. Next factor is occupation. Certain occupations where exposure to carcinogen is common, like tar manufacturing, certain oils, textile industries, etc. The workers are susceptible to cancer. Like leather workers are shown to have a higher rate of cancer of buccal cavity. Socioeconomic status. All cancers are common in lower socioeconomic status than higher socioeconomic status of the people. Moving on to the role of habit in development of cancer. Let's discuss use of tobacco in the form of smoking tobacco like bidi, chillam, chutta, cigarette, dhoomti, hookah, hookni, or smokeless tobacco like khaini, mawa, mishri, snuff, jarda, pan masala, and gadakku. Smoked as well as smokeless tobacco contains thousands of chemical compounds. Many of these compounds are not only irritants and toxins, but they are also carcinogens. The most potent carcinogen in tobacco are the tobacco-specific nitrosamines, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, and many others. Burning of tobacco forms a partial oxidation, leads to formation of epoxide in the benzopyrene and benzoanthracene tars in the tobacco, which themselves are not carcinogens and transform them into carcinogens. Epoxides are not formed in smokeless tobacco, so such products are not carcinogenic, despite the claim of several organizations do not produce a high incidence of squamous cell carcinoma than in the non-smoker. Role of alcohol in cancer. Alcohol is a beverage which has claimed for several oral cancers. Consumptions of alcohol result in dehydration of the mucosal epithelium. Hence, epithelium become more susceptible to cancer changes. Usually, heavy drinking is associated with the heavy smoking. Some studies suggested that the alcohol makes the epithelium more susceptible and exposure to tobacco is also present. Various agents that have important role in development of cancer. Physical agent, chemical agent, mechanical factors, biological agent, nutritional agent. Coming on to the physical agents, continuing heat like due to severe chutta or bidi smoking, sunlight exposure, UV radiation exposure, ionizing radiation, solar radiation. Sunlight and other ionizing radiations present in the environment plays a vital role in the development of the oral cancer. Squamous cell carcinoma and basal cell carcinoma are common in males who are exposed to outdoor work like farmers, sailors, etc. A high rate of leukemia among dentists and physicians is thought to be due to increased exposure to the ionizing radiations. Continuing heat due to severe chuta smoking may cause oral cancer, which is usually seen in coastal area of Andhra Pradesh, leads to oral cancer. An area of white leukoplakic area is earliest lesion observed in development of cancer. Now coming on to the chemical agents, the person working in coal industry, tar industry, come in contact with benzopyrene and its derivative, nitrosamines and ethionine, have greater risk of cancer development. Person working in textile industries come in contact with azodis, which is a known carcinogen. Alpha toxin present in the rotten groundnut is considered as carcinogen. Prolonged consumption of oral contraceptive which contain hormones has shown carcinogenesis. Others are nicotine and phenestrine. Now mechanical factors: chronic irritation, friction, trauma resulting in cancerous changes, ill-fitting dentures, overhanging fillings, sharp tooth cusp, broken teeth, red teeth, all these can lead to cancer development. Coming on to the biological factors, patients suffering from HIV and syphilis have more chances of developing cancer. Patients with hepatitis are more prone to development of hepatic carcinoma in future. Epstein-Barr virus, it is the causative agent for Burkitt lymphoma, which may develop in the oral cavity. And patients suffering from Candida albicans have also more chances for development of cancer. Coming on to the nutritional agents, deficiency of proteins, vitamins and minerals have a role in the initiation of oral cancer. Malnutrition can lead to decreased immunity that can further lead to development of cancer. Oral cancer is commonly found in low socioeconomic status, hence correlation has been drawn with the nutrition status. Alpha toxins, ethionine, nitrosamines may be present as food contaminants, thus they can also be included under nutritional agents. Overweight and obesity are established risk factor specifically for adenocarcinoma but not squamous cell carcinoma of the esophagus. In developing countries, around 60% of cancer of oral cavity, pharynx and esophagus are thought to be a result of micronutrient deficiency related to restricted diet that is low in fruits and vegetable and animal products. Environmental factor: air pollution has resulted in inclusion of certain harmful chemical substance into the atmosphere like acrylonitrite, alkyl sulfates, aromatic amine, etc. Exhaust fumes containing benzopyrenes and other polycyclic hydrocarbons in the atmosphere can cause cancer. Uranium miners, radiologists, workers in the nuclear plants are more prone for cancerous changes in the body. So we have discussed various factors affecting development of cancer. Thank you.